In this video, the event service as used in the FAA-SAA dissemination pilot is presented. This presentation is focused on its use in the pilot study. The event service, however, is domain independent and can be applied for the dissemination of any kind of feature-related data. The event service was implemented by the Institute for Geoinformatics of the University of Münster. Especially members of the Swizzle team working on SensorWeb and web-based geoprocessing were involved. The Institute is an active OGC member and is currently contributing to various activities of the OGC, such as the working groups for the Sensor Observation Service 2.0 and Publish Subscribe. Furthermore, the activities include the participation in the last OGC web services testbeds and their aviation threats. First, the general workflow of the communication with the event service is explained. The involved components are the event service in the middle, a subscriber and a receiver on the right side, and a producer on the left side. As a first step, the subscriber sends a subscribe request to the service. This request contains a reference to a receiver and optional filter statements to express the interest in specific events. The service response contains an ID, which can be used to manage the subscription, for instance, to cancel it. When the producer sends a notification to the event service, it is matched against the filters in the existing subscriptions. If a filter is satisfied, the notification is forwarded to the according receiver. The service operations used in this workflow are specified in the OASIS Web Services Notification Suite of Standards and the OGC Sensor Event Service discussion paper. In the workflow description, the subscriber and the receiver were separate entities. In this pilot study, the functionality is united in the client programs, which will be presented later on. The producers are called event service adapters. They are built as a bridge between the existing web feed serving airspace activation schedules and the event service. First, the adapter has to request the current schedules from the web service. For the further use, the schedule information has to be enriched and encoded in AIXM 5.1. To do so, the affected airspaces are requested from a web feature service. With this information, a new AIXM time slice is produced. It is sent to the event service for further dissemination. Here you can see how a single schedule information as provided by the web feed looks like. The first parameter identifies the schedule. The second parameter holds the ID of the affected airspace. It is followed by the activation status. Here it is hot or activated for use. Next, the airspace type is given. After the name of the airspace, the start time and the end time for the activation are provided. Parameter 8 and 9 define the flight levels that are affected by this activation. In order to be transformed into an AIXM time slice, this data has to be enriched with the baseline data. For this purpose, the airspace ID has to be mapped to the AIXM designator, which can be used to access a web feature service. In the FAA-SAA dissemination pilot, the event service and the adapters are used for the dissemination of airspace activation updates. The updates are retrieved, enriched, filtered, and forwarded to interested clients. The communication is push-based. This means that the updates are delivered to the clients as soon as they are available. Another advantage is that clients can subscribe once and keep being updated. No repeated queries to a web feature service for the latest information have to be performed. In the subscriptions, filters can be defined to restrict the updates that are sent to a client. These filters can be expressed using the OGC filter encoding and web services notification topic expressions. For example, filters can be built for spatial regions, like a buffer around a flight path. They can also depend on the temporal properties of the activation, to restrict the updates to those that affect the flight time. Or they may use any other property, like the airspace ID or the flight level. All these filters can be combined by logical operators, such as AND or OR.